I'm Dr. Adel Zurob, a pulmonologist and critical care physician with Mayo Clinic Health System, and I'm here to address questions you may have about robotic-assisted bronchoscopy. So the challenge has always been, how do you sample those lesions that are outside of the branches, those apples, so to speak? And in the past, the best we had was to take an x-ray while we're doing the procedure and try and approximate where our tool is going. With robotic-assisted bronchoscopy, we take the CT scan that the patient has had before the procedure, we feed it into a computer program that then generates a 3D map for us. And we take this 3D map and the images that the CT has, marry them together, and we get a GPS, an overlay of a path that we can follow when we go inside of the lung. So we go with the scope, and on the screen, I can see my scope, and I can see this path, and I just follow it with a little console, like a game console, like you're driving and you're following this line until we get to our target. When we get to it, we can see it on the virtual image, and then at that point we use other tools to verify the accuracy of what we're doing. So we use an ultrasound device that we pass that allows us to see this mass or nodule. We use the x-ray also to confirm where we're at. And once we're happy that we are in the right spot, now we can deploy our tools like a needle, like a forceps, to try and get samples. We often will have a pathologist in the room who will look at the samples we're getting and say yes, they're adequate or they're not. So with this, we're able to sample smaller lesions. We're able to sample lesions that you cannot sample from the outside with a CT-guided biopsy, which is the other way we can sample things. And so this hopefully will allow us to bring certainty to smaller nodules as to whether they're cancer and they require, you know, resection or chemo or radiation, or whether they have an alternative explanation that could be treated simpler with medications or just watching. So this is one tool. It's not the only tool, but it's a very important advance. So we think by doing this, we're able to provide an earlier diagnosis at a point when hopefully a cancer is curable rather than continuing to wait because something is too small for us to sample any other way. To learn more, please click on one of the links on the screen or the description below.